There are three basic checks that you should make before releasing any app that will cover the majority of accessibility scenarios. First, you need to provide content descriptions for user interface components that do not have visible text. This is most important for buttons, checkboxes, and images because these components often influence the flow of the app. So use the Android Content Description Layout attribute or the Set Content Description Java method to provide this information for accessibility services. Note, however, that decorative graphics are the exception to this rule, but be sure to indicate this by setting content description to null. Second, you should make sure that users can navigate your screen layouts by using the hardware-based or software directional controls. Many users will employ D-pads, trackballs, keyboards, and navigation gestures, and you should be confident that your app will support these. Put an exceptional focus on ensuring that any UI element that accepts input is reachable. In some cases, this may require that UI components are focusable, or else you may need to adjust the focus order to be more logical. Finally, audio feedback must always have a secondary feedback mechanism to support users who are deaf or hard of hearing. For example, a sound alert for the arrival of a message must be accompanied by a system notification, haptic feedback, or some other visual cue.